Hey guys, Dan here from VHIX411. Today in front of me I have a Subaru ECU, and in this video I will show you how we're going to take the key information from the original ECU, the VIN number, and if this thing had a tune in it, we will transfer everything from original bad ECU to a good used donor ECU. Now if it's your first time here, click the subscribe, like, and do share. Now, if you've seen my other video on older Subarus, similar case, except a little bit bigger, they have an EPROM. That video, you can see it. I'll put a link below if you have an older one. You can program those with an EPROM programmer. Now, this guy right here is a processor, so it's, you won't be able to just clip on an EPROM and read it. So this is an R5F 72531 processor, and you will need to connect it to the OBD line. If you can see, I got mine's connected, and then read the whole processor through it. It's a P flash, D flash. Now I'm gonna be using hex tag for this job, and we already got it hooked up over here. So I'll just show you how it's done reading it, and of course we'll just hook up to this guy right here, and we will write it. Now, if you need the service done, you can, at the end of the video, there will be a link, or in the description below. All right. So I already have my hex tag set up over here. Here's a Subaru, here's a Denso. This is the processor that we have. We're gonna read it in factory mode. Now, boot mode, usually if we can't read it through the OBD, then you're gonna have to solder to a specific spot where the processor is just to boot it up and read it. Now, I have my diagram over here set up. We are gonna make sure we have everything set up correctly. Power, power, can, and then power and ground. So I'm good. I'm set up over here perfectly fine. So what I'm gonna do is a P flash. I will click read, and it's gonna try to communicate to the ECU and read the P flash. And we will save it as original P flash, and then of course, we're gonna do the D flash, save it as original. And then of course, we always love to save the original file from a new donor ECU just in case. So while it's reading, we will fast forward through it. Like I said, meanwhile, if you like my videos, click that like button. Do share if you need the service done, link below or in the, or at the end of the video. All right, so read that. We will save it as Subaru. I'll just click over here. Subaru ECU original. And of course, it's over here already says it's a P flash. So I will click on my D flash and read my D flash. D flash is a little quicker. It's a smaller portion of a memory. So this won't take long. And again, we will save it as Subaru ECU original. Now we'll click save and we're done here. So what I'm gonna do is disconnect. So we read that VIN number, the key information, it will sync our donor ECU with the cluster. And if it's a smart key, it will link it with a smart box, which is the security computer. All right, so we'll click, or we'll put a pin here, in this pin here. Now we got a power supply here. We have a ground here. And then we also have two power supplies on the very top right. Okay, good connection. Make sure nothing's shorting out. In correct spots, confirming with my diagram right there. And we are gonna do the same thing. I'll just read the D flash. and save it. We always love to save it. Plus, while you're reading, you make sure you have a good connection. So, yep, we have a good connection. It's reading it. So, I'll just put Subaru ECU. I'll just put a new. Save that. And then, of course, we'll read the P flash. Again, this one takes a little bit longer, so I will just fast forward through this. All right, I'll click ECU, new, save that. Now what we're gonna do is a PFLASH, we wanna write a new file from the, we were gonna write a original file. So I have it as Subaru, and then we have it as original. And of course we're trying to read the PFLASH, so make sure you're choosing the right file. So we'll go Subaru original PFLASH. So this is original file, confirming it, and we're gonna write the original file now. So everything from the original guy right here, if it was ever tuned, it will be transferred, VIN number will be transferred, and of course key information that will sync the smart computer, smart keys, or if it's a regular key with the blade, it will transfer that information also in there. So as you can see, the PFLASH written pretty quickly. Why? Is because it's not changing the whole file. Looks like all the tune file, everything original. It just changed the location that were different, which were the VIN and the key information. So Subaru, Subaru original DFLASH. So DFLASH original, open it up, DFLASH, and it's gonna write this guy. Now, like I said, if you need the service, link below or at the end of the video. Otherwise, you see how quickly and easy it is if you have the right tools. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.